Welcome back to Hum Ek Hain, Harmony, the All India Indian Public Schools Conference Visual Art Festival 2022. This Visual Art Fest would be incomplete without our able and ace keynote speaker and panelists who will be assessing the participant in this festival for their creative skills. May I now invite Kanak Joshi, Captain Sri Ambika House, to introduce our first keynote speaker of the day, Dr. Raghavendra Rao H. Kulkarni.
Creativity takes courage, and as Sadhguru rightly said, Indian art is not an imitation of nature in its physical form, but in its fundamental skeletal geometry. The morning session was enriched by the presence of His Highness Maharaja Gat Singh Ji and our guest of honor, veteran artist Jisu Krishna Shetty. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure for me to introduce our keynote speaker for the day, Dr. Raghavendra Rao H. Kulkarni. In the words of Dr. Kulkarni, Karnataka offers an encyclopedic reference material on any aspect of temple architecture from multiple angles for a scholar wanting to delve into Indian sculpture. Well said, sir. A keen researcher, Dr. Kulkarni has to his credit various research papers in both Kannada and English. We are blessed to have such an eminent artist with us who has published many prestigious books and monographs, which include Kinnalada Chitrakale, Vijayanagara Shilpakale, Pre and Early Chalukya Sculpture, Ratnadipa, New Dimensions of Indian Art, History and Theory, and the list goes on and on. Possessing a strong personality, a co-editor in the work of Splendors of Ganjafa Art, he has taken on the mantle of spreading the rich beauty and heritage of Indian art far and wide by participating in various national and international conferences and symposiums. A man of substance who imparts his skill and knowledge to brighten young minds, Sir has given lectures at Suchitra Film and Cultural Foundation, Shudra Cultural Institute, Bengaluru, Lalit Kala Academy, New Delhi, Rashtriya Kala Manch at Bolpur on various topics including Indian art appreciation, Ajanta New Dimensions and art education. Sir, you're truly an inspiring person. He has been a member of well-known professional organizations, namely Karnataka Itihas Academy, Bangalore since 1995, Archaeological Society of India, New Delhi since 2010, and is an advisory board member, NGMA, Bangalore since 2018. He is the recipient of Sri Shushmindra Tirth Award by Mantralayam Sri Raghavendra Mutt for his contribution in the field of art and culture, Chalukya Samman by Bagalkot District Administration for his contribution in the field of Badami Chalukya art and architecture. Dr. Raghavendra Rao H. Kulkarni, an illuminating and powerful personality, is presently the professor and HOD, Department of History of Art in the College of Fine Arts, Karnataka Chitrakala Parishad, Bengaluru, and the coordinator of Visual Art PhD Research Center and Internal Quality Assurance Cell. Sir has been a great inspiration to us. I cordially invite Dr. Raghavendra Rao H. Kulkarni to the stage to encourage our young participants to apply their creative skills and portray their own stories. Thank you, Gyanam Brahma.
Very good morning to all the participants and organizers too. It is a proud moment for any visual arts student to be part of this mega event organized by the Rajmata Krishna Kumari Institute. In fact, visual art is a subject which gives you not only the mental relief but also enriches your knowledge. Visual art has a rich tradition, Indian art especially. The visual art as part of the Indian art, it has developed to such an extent that today we are in a position to say that our country was like this, our temples were like this, our ancestors were like this. It is a fact that we should be in a position to understand how rich was the tradition, how rich we need to improve upon. These are the few areas I would like to enlighten you today. The Indian art, especially, you know, the where you come from, I mean, where the event is organized, the state of Rajasthan, known for the miniature culture, the rich, vibrant colors. Though many of us, we think that Rajasthan is mainly of a deserts. But desert is one of the part. But the forts, the rich culture, the tradition that evolved in the state definitely gives us a new dimension to think and also develop our visual art culture. Visual art, in the context of the India, we can trace back to the prehistoric period. The prehistoric paintings, they established the tradition of murals. The mural tradition, what we understand in today's context, is totally different, and what our ancestors did were totally different. But there is a continuous development from the day one to present day. So the prehistoric to Indus culture, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Punjab, and the Indus civilization sites like Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, which are in present days Pakistan, were previously part of India. The site like Rakhigari and Dholavira, Lothal in Gujarat as well as in Rajasthan, they establish a tradition that the culture, the architecture, the sculpture, the terracotta art, especially terracotta art through making the seals, was so rich that not only it introduces the technology, but also aesthetic values that they evolved. So if we look at the rich historical mural tradition in India, Ajanta murals stand as the magnum opus of the Indian mural tradition. Not only they establish a new dimension to the Indian art, but also to the art of narrating the stories, illustrating the stories of the life of Buddha. It's not just life of Buddha. There are many narrations that they evolve the new trend into the visual art. There are civilian subjects, animals like flora, fauna, creepers, designs, which inspire even today to design the textile, design the jewelry, design even our attire and also architecture. So rich is our tradition. So now we should be proud to re-evaluate, understand and reconcile our tradition into the present day visual art context. So the tradition like miniature school, it's such a wonderful thing, like the artists who were part of the painting the larger spaces like walls. Suddenly when the new trend developed into manuscript painting followed by miniature painting, from just imagine a person painting 20 feet canvas, 20 feet by 10 feet canvas, now has to paint only 7 inches by 9 inches space. This is what is artist talent is. Artists' flexibility to accommodate themselves into the given space. So that is how the new dimension to the art develops. Here artists in miniature, they were equally skillful, equally imaginative, equally aesthetically enriched. The same has been adopted into the miniature trend also. So that is how we come across schools like Malwa, Mewat, Bundi, Kota, Nurpur, Jaipur, Udaipur, whatnot. Followed by Pahadi schools like Basholi, Gulier, Kangra. So the rich tradition also evolved with the religious and socio-political touch. The great composers like Kabir Das, Mirabai, Bhanu Das, all such great personalities inspired the visual art to greater extent. So, keeping in mind, when we even look at the architectural examples, the group of Roda temples and the temples in Gujarat like Modera, the well like Patan, Mehsana district's Patan, Rani Ki Vav, they always mesmerize us how technologically those people were able to construct such a beautiful temples. Similarly, the temples in Karnataka like Badami, Patadakkal, Aihole, Khajurahos, Yellora, Kailashanatha temple, when we look at a linear art history of India, there every 100 years there is a change, there is a new trend, there is a new dimension in the visual art. When we look at the colonial period, which is the almost beginning of the 18th, 19th century, the colonial trend totally changes our dimension of looking at the visual art. Today, what we are trying to learn, what we have been learning, is influenced by the colonial art, colonial academicism. But there is also a necessity for us to redefine indigenous roots, redefine our own native art trends, art schools, art traditions, to inculcate once again back to the traditions. Not that India has not achieved the greatest excellence in the art. It has achieved long ago. Of course, today we are in the age of digital era. One European scholar wrote a beautiful essay. A scholar called Walter Benjamin, he wrote in 1930s, in the age of mechanical reproduction. I reframe it as in the age of digital reproduction. So we are today in the age of digital reproduction, and our visual art is an alternate for the other traditional form of the education. Visual art helps us to not only get the mental relief, and also to enrich our knowledge, and it creates employability in such a manner that industry, every level, every aspect of the life needs an artist. So the painting, sculpture, printmaking, animation, anything connected with the visual art would be fine in getting a good employability. So I also developed a phrase called art for all. Art for all, sab logon ke liye kala rahna chahiye. So the art gives you a mental health and also a refreshment, new energy, but it also gives you a good emolument also. The industry needs artists not in hundreds but in thousands. Especially animation industry today requires more than 50,000 artists every year. India has become a hub of new era art and also new era animation films. So many private organizations have started, the animation companies, like Bangalore being a hub of animation industry, the animation companies like Technicolor Gaming, Technicolor Cinema, so Dreamworld, etc. No, everywhere there is an opportunity. Now IT industry is also recruiting artists like anything. I am proud to say that my institute, Chitrakala Parishat, where I belong to, 80% student get their recruitment before they complete their final year examination. So this is what is the strength of the visual art today. Being independent artist is one aspect. Being a philanthropist also is another aspect, but as a good citizen, good artist, and also good human being, all these issues, all these aspects become part of everyone's life who are artists. So I congratulate all of you, all the participants, and especially thank the Rajmata Krishna Kumari Institute for hosting this mega event, especially the visual art event. And I thank all the organizers, the strength behind putting up together all events, and I wish a grand success to all the events. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. We feel blessed and humbled by your benign presence. Art is something that inspires people, something that transports us into different realities and moves us into the subconscious places that we didn't know existed. The IPSC Visual Art Fest from 18 to 20 July 2022 will encompass the following 16 events: still life, portrait drawing, outdoor landscape, digital poster making, POP relief work, tile mosaic, doodling, collage making, cartooning, mandala, string art, face painting and headgear, macrame, clay modeling, imagination art, and flower making.
Our panelists for the events are Mrs. Shalini Soni Mazumdar, Mr. Ram Pratap Verma, Mr. Vinod Patel, Mr. Jay Ranjit, Mrs. Bhavna Basumatri, Mrs. Moshami Ganguly, Mr. Jayanto Khan, Dr. Neeja Chandra Peters, Mr. Mohan Pal, Mr. B.N. Vichar, Mr. Ashish Ghosh, Mr. Ashok Kumar Gopalan, Mrs. Jaskamal Jeet Kaur, Mr. Suresh K. Nair, Mr. Venugopal V.G., and Mr. Rupesh Nanaya.
In a short while, we shall be displaying the working videos of the first five events: still life, portrait drawing, outdoor landscape, digital poster making, and POP relief work. May I now request Kanak Joshi to introduce our first two judges.
It's a great pleasure for me to introduce the judges of today's mega event. Our first judge, Mrs. Shalini Soni Mazumdar Ma'am, is a proficient painter and has worked as an illustrator for mainstream and scholastic children's books. In addition, she has undertaken commercial design assignments for various independent clients. Ma'am is an active member of the Society of Children's Book Writers and Illustrators, the only professional body designed specifically for individuals who write, illustrate, and translate for children and young adults. In her 8 years of teaching experience, Ma'am conducted several workshops on miniature paintings at Government College of Fine Arts, Chandigarh, and Karnataka Chitrakala Parishad, Bangalore. An award-winning professional artist, she has won Certificates of Merit in Kala Sangati 2008, National Level Art Competition, Hyderabad, H.K. Kejriwal Foundation, Bangalore, and for Traditional Painting of the Year 1996-97, awarded by Rajasthan Small Industries Corporation. An exuberant personality, she's done some acclaimed group shows, which include Mini Print Goa, in collaboration with Directorate of Art and Culture, Government of Goa, Panjim, International Drawings and Graphic Prints Exhibition, Chandigarh, Mahua Art Gallery and H.K. Kejriwal Foundation, the Leela Galleria, Bangalore, and many more. She has shown her virtuosity in notable solo shows at Jawahar Kala Kendra, Jaipur, Palette Art Gallery, Jodhpur, Karnataka Chitrakala Parishad, and Bangalore Museum Gallery, Chandigarh. Blessed are we to have you as one of our judges. Welcome, ma'am. Our next judge is Mr. Ram Pratap Verma. Known for his remarkable art, direction, and production in documentary films like Worli Paintings, Wall Painting, The Vanishing Treasure, and Biography of Sant Namdev. A dynamic personality, sir has participated in various camps. Some of them are National Camp by QCI New Delhi, National Camp by National Lalit Kala Academy at Banaras Hindu University, Banaras, National Camp by NZCC Ratnavali by Kurukshetra University, Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy, and the list goes on. A leading light for many young artists, sir has added many feathers to his cap. He has received the AIFACS Award in 86th Annual Art Exhibition, New Delhi, the HIFA Award, and a merit certificate by Punjab Lalit Kala Academy. A wonderkind, sir has been doing many group exhibitions like group show at Nehru Center, London, group show by Arts Aroma at Hyderabad, group show by Zazen Art Center, Chandigarh, group show of paintings at Art Entrance, Kala Ghora, Mumbai since 1997. An eminent personality, he has also been a part of Chandigarh Lalit Kala Academy and Chandigarh Sahitya Academy. He has really set an example for enthusiastic young artists. Sir, you really have been an inspirational personality, and we are truly blessed to have you as one of our esteemed judges. Welcome, sir. May I now invite Gauri Bakshi, Captain Sri Shakti House, to take you through the journey of the first two events. Thank you.
Thank you, Kanak. In still life, our first event of the IPSC Visual Art Fest, our enthusiastic participants celebrated unity and diversity. They chose the object and, using their artistic skills, created a ravishing piece of art. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming in one of our luminaries of today's event, Mrs. Shalini Soni Majumdar. Ma'am, I cordially invite you to the stage to encourage our young participants by sharing your insight into their work.
Hello everyone. I would first like to thank Rajmata School and IPSC for giving me the opportunity to be a part of the Visual Art Fest this year. I'm Shalini Soni Majumdar, an artist and children's books illustrator. So I began as a visual artist, and I had started my formal education with joining Shri Lal Singh Ji Bhatti's art school to learning miniature paintings from him. After that, I did my graduate diploma in commercial arts, and finally I did my master's in art history from Punjab University. I'll just quickly share some of my paintings that I did. You can see that I have influences from surrealism and miniature art in my work. I also try to develop a contemporary language for miniature paintings, as you can see in these two pieces here. After my marriage, there was a long gap, and though I was participating in some group shows, I had also started working for small illustration projects. Now I have totally devoted myself full time to illustrating, especially for children's books. Some early influences were these storybooks from my childhood. Some of these are now collectibles, like this book of fairy tales by Dean Publishing and illustrated by my favorite twin sister illustrators, Janet and Annie Graham Johnston. Another one is The Odyssey by Homer, published by Hamlin. And these are some early influences that I still thank for my interest in images and stories. But there isn't any shortage of amazing illustrators today. I refer their work for inspiration often, and I go to Pinterest and their Instagram accounts to do so. I also purchase books whenever I can so that there are ready reference in hand and inspiration when I don't want to go to the net for browsing. And you get a very good idea of how all these images will work in actual print. Now, without taking much time, I'll share my process for illustrating a picture book. But first, I'll show you my first illustration project with a big publisher in Delhi, the Juggernaut Books. This was done during the first COVID lockdown, and I had just begun exploring digital illustrations. This was a blessing because I could work and send the digital images without having to scan and digitize handmade art. So the book was done in good time, and I'm also very happy to share that the book was number one in the kids' literature. Now I'll give a quick look at the process involved in creating a picture book. I'm taking this book by Darina Dejeva, a US-based author who self-published this on Amazon. So this helped decide the size and even the number of pages we were to have. The first step was to design the main character, Rosie. With some research and trials, this was finally achieved, and we did the same for the other characters. We also did some research on what the savanna plant life and landscape would look like, and took some ideas from some other picture books as well, like this one right here. The whole story is then laid out in spreads, and the rough illustrations are worked on it. This helps us to get the story and images in sync and find the best image to tell the story. This is called storyboarding. The final work on the spreads begin after this, and these are a few cover ideas that we ran before finally deciding on the last one. These are a few upcoming books. One is a picture book on yoga for young kids. And this one is for older readers about 100 incredible women from the Vedic age. There are a couple more in the pipeline. I feel there's so much yet to learn about illustrating, so I take up courses on domestica related to illustration for children's books. Like this course here, which takes you through the technical aspects involved in creating a picture book. Though I'm busy working on book projects, I try to do some daily art practice. This keeps me in touch and also helps build a database of images I can refer to for future works. There are various prompts I refer to for topics to illustrate and create a diverse portfolio. Though I'm not so technology friendly, I do my best in keeping my social media presence on Instagram and updating my website. I'm also a member of Illustrators for Hire, which connects illustrators to potential clients. And Society for Children's Books Writers and Illustrators is another great place to connect with other professionals of this field. They have various awards and grants you can apply for and various other opportunities you can avail. You'll find many such contests and calls to participations on many established groups. There are so many avenues open for illustrators today, other than in print medium like books, magazines, and comics, even on as surface patterns on products. Animation and gaming is also another field that requires high quality specialized illustrations. I was a part of one such game design. It was out of my comfort zone, but I learned a lot of new things, and I can now understand the hard work and skill that is required for this. I was assigned to work for the story sequence, the character design, and other variables of the actual game, like backgrounds, sprites, etc. This is just the beginning level, and you can see more levels as you proceed further. I'm unfortunately not very good at playing the game, so I cannot take you to the next levels. So there are many colleges that nowadays in India offer courses in illustrations. The two that come to my mind are Riaz Academy in Bhopal, and the other one is the Srishti Institute for Art and Design in Bangalore. I'm sure you can get more details on the internet and from your teachers. And last but not the least, I would like to thank everyone for listening to me, and I really hope that anything that I have shared today was useful to any one of you in any way. And I wish all the students all the very best for their future. Keep creating and be happy. Have a good day. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your inspiring young talent. The object stays still, but the imagination is what moves the onlookers, and our participants showcase their vivid imaginations beautifully. Now, let us have a look at the working videos of all the participating schools. In the words of M.F. Hussain, they can put me in a jungle and I will still create. A true artist is someone who can create his own world, and when others peep into his world, they catch a glimpse of his soul. In these working videos on still life, we can observe the budding painters creating their masterpieces. Thank you. And now let us admire the final harmony at standstill. Finally, the moment that we've all been waiting for is here. Time to appreciate artistic talent. Let's appreciate art and experience the magical celebration of humanity and harmony by felicitating the following 10 awards to the participants. Creative Art Award goes to Honorable Mention Award goes to Jury's Choice Award goes to High Commendation Award goes to People's Choice Award goes to Special Commendation Award goes to Promising Young Artist Award goes to Future Generation Art Award goes to Artist Beyond the Boundaries Art Award goes to Best Work of Art Award goes to Each and every participant will receive an e-certificate. Hearty congratulations to the award recipients. The next highlight of the day was portrait drawing. Some painters transform the sun into a yellow spot. Others transform a yellow spot into the sun. As they say, face is the index of mind. Ladies and gentlemen, our young painters put their heart and soul into their portraits. The portrait seemed live and revealed the artist's distinct talent. May I now request Sir Ram Pratap Verma to please come up on stage and enlighten the ardent artistic minds.
Namaskar sabhi ko. Main aapki sari pehle to committee ka dhanyawad karna chahunga ki jinhone mujhe aapse रूबरू होने का मौका दिया. तो बच्चों, मैं आज बात करूंगा आपके सामने तीन टॉपिक में आपको बताऊंगा, एक टॉपिक तो है जिसमें से हम शुरुआत करेंगे ड्राइंग को लेकर के। बेसिकली ड्राइंग है क्या चीज? ड्राइंग बेसिकली एक, जब कागज पे जब हम किसी चीज का एक वो ड्राइंग पेंसिल पेन या कुछ भी लेकर के जब हम शुरू करते हैं तो एक बिंदु लगता है, उसको हम बोलते हैं पॉइंट। ये ड्राइंग की डेफिनेशन, ड्राइंग की शुरुआत कैसे होती है, जब हम उसको किसी डायरेक्शन में सीधे लेके जाते हैं तो वो एक, उसको हम बोलते हैं एक लाइन, और जब उसको हम कहीं के भी कर्व दे करके घुमा लेते हैं तो तब वो जाकर के ड्राइंग में कन्वर्ट होती है। इसलिए मैं ये कहना चाहूँगा कि ड्राइंग्स इज नॉट सिंपली कि भी जो सोचते कुछ भी करना है, कि बस उसकी परिभाषा ये है कि एक बिंदु से लेकर के जब हम कर्व में किसी चीज़ को शेप में कन्वर्ट कर देते हैं तो उसे हम ड्राइंग की परिभाषा के अंदर लेते हैं। अब सवाल होता है कि ड्राइंग कितनी तरह की होती है। पहले आती है ड्राइंग जो, जिसे हम ज्योमेट्रिकल ड्राइंग बोलते हैं। ज्योमेट्रिकल ड्राइंग का मतलब ये है कि जो टूल्स की हेल्प से, इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स की हेल्प से जो ड्राइंग की जाती है, जिसे आप लोगों ने कभी मैथमेटिक्स में भी पढ़ा होगा या जो ड्राइंग सब्जेक्ट लेते हैं उसमें ज्योमेट्रिकल ड्राइंग में भी पढ़ा होगा, और उस ड्राइंग को यूज़ करते हैं आर्किटेक्ट्स यूज़ करते हैं, इंजीनियर्स यूज़ करते हैं, उसे हम कहते हैं कि ज्योमेट्रिकल ड्राइंग है। एक होता है फिर जो हमारी फाइन आर्ट से रिलेटेड ड्राइंग आती है, विच इज़ नोन एज ए फ्री हैंड ड्राइंग। फ्री हैंड ड्राइंग में हम क्या करते हैं कि पेंसिल या जो भी इंस्ट्रूमेंट जिससे भी कर जाते हैं उसके लिए, चाहे पेंसिल ले ली, चाहे हमने कोई ब्रश ले लिया, या हम चारकोल ले लेते हैं, जो भी आपके पास रिसोर्सेज हो, जो अवेलेबल रिसोर्सेज हो उनके आपसे आप काम करना चाहें, अपनी डिज़ायर जो शेप ड्राइंग का ड्रॉ करना चाहें उससे जो हम काम करते हैं। जैसे कि मैं यहाँ पे आपको बता दूँ कि भाई अगर मैंने ये ड्राइंग यहाँ पे ले करके ऐसे करना है, ये इसके मैंने हेयर बनाए, ये मैंने इसकी आँखें बनाने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ, ये आ गया, तो ये इसको हम एक ड्राइंग से शुरू किया और एक मैंने फेस में कन्वर्ट कर लिया, तो ये है ड्राइंग की परिभाषा। इसके बाद हम बात करेंगे इसमें जो है कंपोजिशन की बात करेंगे, विच इज़ अगेन अ नॉर्मल। कंपोजिशन इज़ ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंपोनेंट। जब हम कोई भी चीज़ का पेंटिंग में कन्वर्ट करना चाहते हैं या उसको पेंटिंग में भी कई मीडियम्स हैं, वाटर कलर मीडियम यूज़ करते हैं, एक्रेलिक यूज़ करते हैं, ऑयल कलर यूज़ करते हैं, या सिर्फ ड्राइंग में रखना चाहते हैं ब्लैक इंक और ब्रश वगैरह के जिसके साथ भी हम काम करना चाहते हैं, तो उसमें भी बड़ी सारी वो चीज़ें हैं, तो उसमें हर चीज़ को कंपोज करना होता है। नाउ व्हाट इज़ कंपोजिशन? कंपोजिशन इज़ एन अरेंजमेंट, एक उस चीज़ को एक स्पेसिफिक जो आपके पास स्पेस है। फॉर एग्जांपल मेरे पास एक ये स्पेस है कि मेरे पास एक पीस ऑफ पेपर है और मुझे इसके अंदर दो बर्ड्स बनाने हैं, तो मुझे उनको ये सोचना चाहिए है कि मैं इनको किस तरह से कंपोज करूं जो कि अलग भी लगे और बैलेंस्ड भी लगे। उसमें दो तीन चीज़ों का ख्याल रखना होता है कंपोजिशन के अंदर। जब आप उस चीज़ को ड्रॉ करते हैं तो वो एक बैलेंस्ड भी लगे, उसमें ब्रीदिंग स्पेस भी हो, उसमें रिदम भी हो, और उसमें जो जब वो लगे तो वो ऐसे ना लगे कि इनकी एक तरफ टेढ़ी है, ये किस तरह से है। फॉर एग्जांपल मैं आपको चीज़ बताता हूँ कि ये मेरी नेगेटिव स्पेस का एक पेंटिंग है, मैंने इसमें नेगेटिव स्पेस ज़्यादा प्ले किया है, और इसमें जो स्टेयर्स हैं या विंडोज़ हैं या चेयर्स हैं मैंने उस तरह से कंपोज किया कि इसके अंदर एक ब्रीदिंग स्पेस रहे। एक दूसरी तरह की कंपोजिशन मैं आपको बता दिखाना चाहूँगा कि इस पेंटिंग के अंदर है, जिसमें मैंने नैरेटिव स्टोरी है ये, इसमें एक बिल्डिंग है और जो काफ़ी सारी जो चीज़ें हैं जो मेरे एलिमेंट्स हैं पेंटिंग्स के, मेरी अपनी पेंटिंग इसमें एलिमेंट्स हैं, तो मैंने इनको इस तरह से अरेंज किया है कि भी मैं सारी अपनी बात कह भी दूँ और इसमें स्पेस का अरेंजमेंट भी ठीक से हो जाए और ये बैलेंस भी लगे, देखने में अच्छे लगे। एक मैं आपको छोटा सा छोटी सी पेंटिंग और कंपोजिशन के तौर पे ये दिखाना चाहूँगा कि ये जैसे है पेंटिंग, मैं इसमें बात कर रहा हूँ और ये मेरी एक सीरीज़ का हिस्सा है विच वॉज डिस्प्लेड इन मैनी एग्जीबिशंस एंड चंडीगढ़ में मैंने सोलो शो किया था, दिल्ली में सोलो शो किया था, चंडीगढ़ में भी किया था। तो इसमें मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि जो मेरे पास मैं बात कर रहा हूँ यहाँ पे लेयर्स ऑफ टाइम, जो आजकल सोसाइटी बन गई है जिसके अंदर एक डेवलपमेंट हुई है, कंक्रीट जिसको हम जंगल की सिर्फ बिल्डिंगे हैं, लाइफ नहीं है उनमें। लाइफ इसलिए नहीं है कि लोग बात करते हैं, इंटरेक्शन कम होती है, इसलिए वो लाइफलेस हैं। तो वो मेरा सब्जेक्ट था, उस सब्जेक्ट को मैंने इस तरह से कंपोज किया है कि मैंने यहाँ पे खाली स्पेस भी रखी, विच इज मिसिंग। यहाँ मैंने दिखाया कि वो बहुत भीड़ है, बहुत ज़्यादा भीड़ है, कंजस्टी होगी, इसमें लाइफ नहीं है, तो इसमें कोई ह्यूमन फिगर नहीं है, और इस स्पेस को मैंने मैनेज किया टू गिव स्मूथ इफेक्ट। अब इसी की कंटिन्यूएशन में बात करेंगे कि भी कलर्स की चॉइस क्या होनी चाहिए। सपोज आप एक क्रिएटिव ड्राइंग कर रहे हैं, क्रिएटिव ड्राइंग के अंदर आप लोगों को सिर्फ एक या दो मीडियम में काम करना है, तो दैट इज़ नोन एज ए ड्राइंग, या सिंगल कलर, या उसको मोनोटोनिक मोनोटोन्स बोलते हैं, दैट मे बी अ ब्लैक, दैट मे बी अ दिस ब्राउन, दैट मे बी अ ब्लू, किसी में भी आप लोग मोनोक्रोमिक जो काम करना चाहते हैं, एक होता है कलर कॉम्बिनेशन। जैसे आपने इन पेंटिंग्स में मैंने जो आपको दिखाई, इसमें मैंने कलर कॉम्बिनेशन लिए और जो प्लीजिंग हैं, कूल कलर्स हैं। कहने का मतलब ये है कि आप अपने सब्जेक्ट के हिसाब से कलर्स की चॉइस रखते हैं। इस कलर्स की चॉइस के अंदर मैंने इसमें सारे कूल कलर्स वो ले रखे हैं, और जो लैंडस्केप से या जो जनरली हम आप जो मेरा सब्जेक्ट है उसमें मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि भाई एक जो डेवलपमेंट हुई है, जो आजकल दुनिया भर के स्काई स्क्रैपर्स बिल्डिंग्स बन रही हैं जिसमें कंजेशन ज़्यादा है, तो उसमें क्या होना चाहिए, तो ये मैंने स्पेस सजेस्ट किया है कि भी इसके अंदर आप स्टेप बाय स्टेप चढ़ो, बट आप ये जो ब्रीथिंग स्पेस है इसको ना खाओ, और उसके कलर्स जो है ना इतने खूबसूरत रखो ताकि अट्रैक्टिव रहें, आपको स्मूथ फीलिंग दें, अच्छा आपको फील आए। वेयर एज की जहाँ पे जो ये है कि ये पुराने सिटीज का कंसेप्ट लेके चले, जो दुनिया भर की भीड़ है, तो इसमें सांस लेने की भी जगह नहीं मिलती, तो इसी कलर्स को मैंने यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा ये कलर कॉम्बिनेशन इस तरह का रखा है कि जिसमें कलर्स को मैंने मिक्स करके दिया है, जो थोड़े से मैले से कलर नज़र आते हैं या जो धुआं सा नज़र आता है। तो आपने इस तरह से अपने कलर्स को प्लान करना है कि जो आपका सब्जेक्ट है जिस पर आप काम करना चाहते हैं वो सब्जेक्ट से रेलेवेंसी हो, वो सब्जेक्ट को आप वो जो है ना उसको जस्टिफाई कर सके वो कलर्स भी। ये जो मैं कहना चाहता हूँ वो यही है। फॉर एग्जाम्पल कि आप अगर मान लो कोई इस तरह का सब्जेक्ट लेना चाहते हैं जो मैंने लिया, या उदास सब्जेक्ट है, या जिसमें आप दिखाना चाहते हैं कि कुछ चीज़ें आपको ठीक नहीं लग रही, उसमें आप फ्रेश कलर्स या लगा दें, तो वो जो है ना कंपोजिशन के अकॉर्डिंग नहीं जाएंगे, और बहुत ज़्यादा सॉफ्ट कलर्स या दूसरे कलर्स पे लगाएंगे, वो भी आपके सब्जेक्ट पे डिपेंड करता है कि आप किस सब्जेक्ट पे काम कर रहे हैं और आपने किस सब्जेक्ट को ले करके। फॉर एग्जांपल आजकल बच्चे जिस मुझे एग्जैक्टली नहीं आइडिया, जो आप कॉलेज में काम कर रहे हो तो आप लैंडस्केप पेंट करते हो, लैंडस्केप के अंदर आपने उस लैंडस्केप को क्यों सेलेक्ट किया है, उसके अंदर किस तरह के कलर्स आपको चाहिए, तो क्योंकि लैंडस्केप तो हमेशा इनवाइट करती है, अट्रैक्ट करती है। कोई गार्बेज के स्टोर को थोड़ा बनाएगा तो उसमें कलर वो लैंडस्केप वाले नहीं लगेंगे, कहीं पे मान लो कूड़े का ढेर है कोई आप वो दिखाना चाहते हैं, तो वहाँ पे आपको कलर की चॉइस को उसके हिसाब से लेना पड़ता है, वही उसको ट्रांसफॉर्म आप करते हैं। तो जब आप कंपोजिशन को पेंट करें, इट मे बी ए स्टिल लाइफ, इट बी ए लाइफ, इट मे बी ए पोर्ट्रेट, इट मे बी अनदर लैंडस्केप, तो आप अपने कलर्स को उसी तरह से चूज करें। तो इसके साथ ही मैं अपनी बात यहाँ पे खत्म करूंगा। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, थैंक यू सो मच।
थैंक यू सर फॉर योर वर्ड्स ऑफ विजडम। We must applaud the efforts of these young talents, how they play with the various themes that come to their mind and use their personal flair to create nothing but the best. Now, let us have a look at the portraits that expressed the untold, the unseen, and brought a whole new world to light for us. Finally, let us now appreciate the young talent by felicitating the following 10 awards to the participants. Creative Art Award goes to Honorable Mention Award goes to Jury's Choice Award goes to High Commendation Award goes to People's Choice Award goes to Special Commendation Award goes to Promising Young Artist Award goes to Future Generation Art Award goes to Artist Beyond the Boundaries Award goes to Best Work of Art Award goes to All participants will receive e-certificates. We congratulate the award recipients. Someone rightly said, art is a kind of language that exists in its own right. The language of art is the language of life. Art is the language of the world. Indian visual art is distinct and amazing. No wonder it has attracted the attention of the whole globe. On that beautiful note, we shall take a small break here. Dear audience and participants, see you all at sharp 2:30 p.m. for our next three events: outdoor landscape, digital poster making, and POP relief work. Stay tuned. Thank you. Gyan and Brahma.